Hi folks, I'm Stephen.
And I'm Matthew, and we're from Yarra Libraries. We're excited to be partnering with our friends at State Library of Victoria to bring you a series of videos showcasing cutting-edge creative technology.
In this episode, we're going to be playing around with some high-powered lasers with our newest machine, the Emblaser 2 laser cutter. We're going to turn this plywood sheet into a precision cut, custom designed book display stand.
Stephen's going to show us how to prepare the book stand project for laser cutting, and I'm going to use a really amazing free piece of software called Polygonia to create beautiful geometric designs that Stephen's then going to use in the project.
All right, let's get into it. For this project, we wanted to keep it pretty simple, so we actually went with a website that allows us to generate a base template. So it's got all these different modules with variables you can tweak, and then click generate and it spits out a design. It's got one for display stands that are typically used for flyers or leaflets, but it works quite well for a book too. So it's a very simple design. We're gonna right click, save as, and as you can see, the file format is an SVG. So you might have heard of popular image formats such as JPEGs and GIFs. They're what's known as a raster image. And what that means is when we zoom in, you'll see that this picture is made up of lots of individual colored squares known as pixels. Scalable vector graphics, on the other hand, are known as vector images. When we zoom into this Yarra Libraries logo, you'll see that the quality is preserved no matter how far in I zoom. Vector images aren't defined by pixels like a raster image. They're defined by points and lines. And this is important when it comes to laser cutting because the machine is essentially tracing these points and lines to cut out the material. You might have heard of some of this software before. Adobe is the industry standard for image editing. Photoshop is used for raster images and Illustrator is used for vector. Today I'm going to be using Gravit Designer. I like it because it runs in a web browser without installation, is easy to use, and the free version has all the features we need. I'm going to start by importing our template. There was actually a couple of issues with this template when I imported it. The first was that the slot was slightly too large, so I've edited it back down to 6 millimeters. The second issue are these weird corner bits on the stand. The generator seems to have created some excess points and lines. They're actually overlapping. Now the laser cutter will follow these lines strictly, so I don't want anything excess there. The last thing to do is just triple check that everything's looking good and the design is nice and neat. It pays to be really careful at this point because it'll save you time and material down the line when it comes to laser cutting. That said, practice makes perfect. Despite this relatively simple design, I still did a ton of testing. We were initially going to make the stand one layer of plywood thick, but, well, you can see how that turned out. Elon does not approve. This is looking good. I'm going to export the updated SVG file and send it to Matthew so he has the dimensions to begin working on the artistic design.
So this is Polygonia Design Suite. This is software that you can open in your browser. It's free to use, but you are limited to downloading only 4 of your designs a month. Now we have 2 important windows. This is where our design will appear according to the dimensions that we've set. And this is our tile. So everything we put in the tile will appear on our design in a tessellated pattern. Now we want to take the dimensions that Stephen have given us. So let's go to the frame. Now we're going to input the dimensions here. So it's 150 by 225, and we're going to set a border width of 22. So this is going to all match up really nicely according to the measurements Stephen's made on the design we have. And now we can start to create the design we want. So let's take these lines off. We're going to change the segment width from 2 millimeters to 4 millimeters. And what this does is change the thickness of the line. Now this is helpful because we're cutting this out of wood. If the line is too thin, the laser cutter can sometimes burn through that entire segment, or because it's made out of wood, it can snap easily. So if you make it 4 millimeters, it makes it a little bit stronger and gives the laser cutter a bit more space to work with. I'm going to start to create a design. So let's just put some things in to start with. Now it's that simple. We just need three lines and we can start to create a design we like. If we use the size option here, we can zoom in. We're going to make it about that big. We're going to go to center, offset and rotate, and center at origin. So there's our design. So this is a really simple way to start. Now if we go up to the design here and click on the points where the lines meet, and you can start to adjust them in this manner. So there's a lot of room to play around and just adjust your lines till you get them just how you want them. In the design that Stephen's created, we're using two pieces of wood stuck together. So instead of cutting out the same design twice, we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to take each of those pieces of wood and cut out a slightly different design so we have a layered effect. Here in the Polygonia design suite, there's a gallery of designs that other people have created. I'm going to show you one as an example. So this design here has multiple pieces of wood stacked together, and the design slightly varied throughout. So that's what we're going to do with our two pieces of wood that are stacked together. So this design we have on the screen right now will be our foreground design, and we're going to create a background design with slightly added details. So to create this effect, we're going to duplicate this design. We're going to use this design as our foreground, and we're going to create a new design as a background. So if we press this button up here, it'll duplicate it and add it to our projects. And now we're going to add some more details to add some more background elements. So let's go back to our design again and just start adding some new lines. Here's our foreground, and here's our background. So when we stack them together, we'll get a really interesting three-dimensional effect. I'm going to send all of these designs over to Stephen and see what he decides to do with them. So if we go to Files, and we go to Download, we can save it as an SVG. So let's save this one as Background, and we're going to press Download Design and Selected Formats. There it is. And we're going to go a foreground, and we'll just do the same. So we just give it a different name and press Download Design.
Great, thanks Matthew. Let's get these designs imported into Gravit and combined with the template. Vector shapes can be combined together through something called Boolean operations. You can add or subtract shapes together to create something more complicated. In this instance, the blue areas are going to be subtracted from the white and will leave us with our final design. Another way to think of this is if you take a bite out of a cookie, the final shape is the cookie minus the shape of your mouth. Boolean operations are a super powerful part of vector graphics and really useful for laser cutting if you can wrap your head around them. Another useful trick is to color code your design. Here I'm using the lighter shade of brown to represent the front layer and the darker shade to represent the back. As I overlap the designs, you get a preview of what the final design will look like once it's all stuck together. Lastly, I'm going to add some custom branding. The Yarra Libraries logo is an SVG, so it's super easy to drop in, the laser cutter will recognize it and it will etch into the design. And we're done. The design's looking really good, so I'm ready to export this out and finally cut this thing. There's one more piece of software, and that is the laser cutter software itself. Here's where you have total control over all the settings of the machine that can greatly affect your final output. For example, these three tiger heads all came from the same design. The reason they look slightly different is because I tweaked the power setting of the laser. A really low power results in light shading, and a high power results in dark shading. The design gets color coded here too. Red represents the areas that are going to be cut all the way through, which is typically an outline. And black represents partial etchings that don't cut all the way through but get engraved into the material, which is perfect for text. You can even get a preview of the machine's path. Here we can see it's etching the letters in red hot reeds. It always pays to play this back before the final cut. Okay, the time has come.
Now witness the firepower of this fully armed and operational laser cutter.
Fire. I honestly never get tired of watching the laser cutter in action. Perhaps it's because I'm seeing all that hard work pay off. Or maybe I'm just feeling a little lightheaded.
Laser cutting can produce some pretty toxic fumes, so you should always cut in a well-ventilated area. Outside is obviously the best, but if you can't do that, make sure you run your exhaust through a fume extractor or you're wearing a face mask. If you haven't got either of those, you're going to have to get a little bit more creative.
All done. Let's check it out. It's looking really good. Unfortunately, some bits didn't cut all the way through. If I was cutting this design again, I'd slow the laser speed down a smidge and that would resolve it. But for the time being, I just have to poke these bits out. Very satisfying. At this stage, we can finally get a sense of what the two layers are going to look like once they're overlapped. I love the sense of depth that the design creates. Laser cutting can leave some burn marks, but a quick sand will clear them right up. When it comes to gluing, I'm just using PVA glue from Zart. Make sure you spread out the glue evenly and use something to hold it together while it dries. These bulldog clips work to treat, but you can also use rubber bands or really whatever you've got lying around. I knew these books would come in handy one day. Leave it to dry overnight and then we're done. Overall, I'm really happy with how this turned out. Matthew's design is really eye-catching. There's nothing left to do but to display my favourite books.
I'm really happy with how that one turned out. If you'd like to learn more about how we did it, we're going to have a Q&A session on September the 30th. This is a great opportunity for those that are new to laser cutting to come back and ask us some questions about how we did it. We're going to talk about the software that we used. We're going to talk about the settings on the laser cutter. And we're just going to go through the whole process from start to finish again. Also, when we're ready to open again, we're going to be running some hands-on laser cutting workshops. This means you'll be able to create a design, you'll be able to watch the laser cutter in progress, and you'll be able to take your designs home with you. If you're interested in any of these programs, check out our website, sign up to our newsletter, and keep updated.
Thank you to our friends at State Library Victoria for inviting us to be part of the Creative Tech Fridays series. We had a load of fun making these episodes, and if you enjoyed watching this one, I strongly encourage you to check out the others. Jackie and I made a Japanese-style borrow bag using the Cricut Maker, and Matthew and Thomas sampled sounds from Bagunga and Onion Library and put together an absolute banger of a music track. If you've got any suggestions for future videos, please let us know. Maybe you'd like to learn how to 3D print one of these guys. Or perhaps you're curious about virtual reality. Or maybe you'd like to learn how to design one of these guys while in virtual reality for 3D printing. Now we're talking. Thanks for watching. See you next time.